about him. Jesus says concerning the bird, he don't work. Hello?
All right.
And he don't receive no wages.
No wages.
That's what Jesus meant when he said he doesn't sow. Neither does he reap. He don't work for nobody. He don't punch no clock.
No clock.
Ain't nobody looking for him early in the morning to work till late in the evening.
Right.
He ain't waiting on no payday.
No.
He ain't waiting on no ship to come in.
No.
He ain't waiting by the phone for the phone to ring. He's not waiting on the mailman to show up. Jesus said, look at him.
Look at him, sir.
He don't even work. No wages coming in. And he don't store into no bonds.
No.
Notice the Lord didn't say, look at the ant.
No.
Because the ant work all the time.
All the time.
Come on in the room when you can.
No.
Oh, baby, that ant is working all summer.
Yeah.
To lay up for the winter.
No.
Jesus said, don't look at him now. Because he's working all the time.
All the time.
He didn't say, look at the chipmunk. Or look at the squirrel. As they gather nuts up for the winter. No. He said, I want you to look at an animal that don't work for nobody.
That's right, son.
He ain't trying to store nothing up.
Right.
He says, but your heavenly Father feeds him.
Yes,
y'all get that?
Yeah.
There's a worm somewhere with his name on it. And he ain't got to worry about whether he gonna find. All he got to do is just get out of that.
Yes.
And God gonna make sure there's a worm somewhere just for him.
Yes.
This shows me that my God is concerned about the birds. Look at Matthew chapter 10 and verse number 29. Matthew chapter 10 and verse number 29. My God is concerned about the birds. The Bible says here, are not two sparrows sold for a farthing? Now, a farthing is a type of denomination of money that originated in England, was transferred to Great Britain and then to the United Kingdom. And it actually measures out to be 1/4 of a penny.
Yes, sir.
1/4 of a penny. That means if you cut a penny in half and then half on the half,
yes,
you have a farthing. And you can buy you two birds for a half of a half of a penny.
Yes.
If anybody ever tell you ain't worth a half of a half of a penny, they say that your value is less than a half of a farthing. Amen. And so what the Lord is showing us is that the value of the bird is so low that you can buy two of them for 1/4 of a penny. Notice what he says, and not one of them shall fall on the ground without your Father. Did you hear what the Master said? He said, but now, when it comes to you, verse number 30, the very hairs of your head are all numbered. That's how closely God pays attention to you. He know how many hairs you got in your head.
Wow.
And then he says, fear not, therefore ye are of more value than many sparrows. Look at what Dr. Luke says about it when you get to Luke chapter 12.
Yes.
And beginning at verse number 6, Dr. Luke paints an even more vivid picture, because he says, if you buy the sparrows in bulk, you get a discount. Come on in the room now. In Luke chapter 12 and beginning at verse number 6, Luke says, are not 5 sparrows sold for 2 farthings? That's buy 2, get 1 free.
Okay.
Amen. If I can get 2 for a penny, and I get for 1/4 of a penny, and I give them a half of a penny, which is 2 farthings, I can get me 5 bags.
Okay.
Once again, the Lord is showing us the insignificant value of a bird. And even though the bird has that little significance in our own eyes, he said, watch how your Father treats them.
Yes,
for not one of them is forgotten before God. If my God takes notice of an insignificant bird when it falls from the sky and hits the ground.
Yes,
I know my God is going to watch over me. This was the motivation for the song. His eye is on the sparrow.
Yes.
I know my God watches over me.
Yes.
If God turns his eyes toward a bird that hits the ground, Jesus says, I am of much more value than many birds.
Yeah.
I'm created in his image, after his own likeness.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, I get in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to worry about God not seeing my trouble.
Yes.
I don't have to worry about God not being aware of what I'm going through.
Right.
What I need to do is what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 11, and beginning at verse number 28, when Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. He said, take my yoke upon you and learn of me. I am meek and lowly in heart. Ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Oh, I discover my God is concerned about the birds. Not only do I see my God being concerned about the birds, but I also see that my God cares for the birds.
All right.
Jesus says that my heavenly Father feeds them. And if I'm worth more than them, the implication is God is going to feed me also.
Mm-hmm.
And so instead of worrying about what's coming, I need to just do what the Lord has commanded me to do when I'm in need, and just ask him for enough to get through this day. And maybe that's the problem, because many of us, look at Matthew chapter 6 with me and beginning at verse number 9, we're already getting through this day. But the anxiety and the anxiousness comes wondering what's going to happen on the next day.
Yes, sir.
We often fear the unknown.
Mm-hmm.
We often worry about things that haven't happened yet.
Mm-hmm.
We often become anxious over something that has yet to occur, not even knowing in reality if what we become nervous about is actually going to occur. And that's the basis of this message. Jesus tells us, even in the 34th verse of this particular chapter, that tomorrow will take care of the things of itself. You got enough to be concerned with trying to get through today. The bird don't worry about tomorrow. The bird has a daily dependence and confidence on God that God is going to see him through. When Jesus taught his disciples to pray, beginning at verse 9 of Matthew chapter 6, he says, after this manner therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day. I ain't worried about tomorrow, Lord. As long as you satisfy my needs for this day, we'll deal with tomorrow when tomorrow comes. Because the reality is, tomorrow not promised to any of us.
That's
why James says, before you make plans for tomorrow, you need to sit down and consider whether or not it's the Lord's will for you to even live to see tomorrow. Because what is your life? It's just like a vapor that appeared for a little while, and then it'll vanish all away. Don't be concerned about what's going to happen on tomorrow. Just thank God and ask him for the blessings of today.
Amen.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 7 and beginning at verse number 7, ask and it shall be given you. Seek
and he shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened.